Hey guys, welcome back for more Life is Strange Before the Storm. So basically last time, a lot of things happened. We did a stage play and we also now know that the lady that we've been seeing is named Sera and she is Rachel's biological mom. So today we're gonna do this one, episode 3, Hell is Empty. Let's begin. I wonder how it's gonna end, how this game is gonna end.
On Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our aerial.
No fucking chance!
I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Yes.
Let's leave.
For real. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
The thing is, yes, Rachel's biological mom, but why kiss her in the lips, right? And the way he kissed her, like, it is like a mistress.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Okay.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook... Her name is Sera, your birth mother.
Can I move?
I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Okay, let's see.
Chloe.
I'm here.
I'm right here. Good. I need you.
Okay, let's see.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sera was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long.
It's basically Rachel. Courtship.
She was so alive. So passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. while the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families. Sera wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape.
Parenthood.
When Sera became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind.
Okay, descent.
However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sera, the need to escape was always there.
Oh, she's a druggie.
For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. I was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied by anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
Reunion.
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true. We kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her, that she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. But after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again and again to keep you safe.
Yeah, that is kind of... I mean, at least he explained it, I mean, right?
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
What? The wife doesn't know?
But now she wants to see me?
Yes, but Rachel, it cannot be.
Why not?
Why not? If that's what Rachel wants.
Drug addiction is a disease. It afflicts everyone, not just the addict. I will not allow you to be victimized by her disease again.
Even if that's true, Rachel could still meet her.
And maybe the fact that she wants to see me means she's gotten better.
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Yes.
Rachel.
I think I need to lie down.
I mean, he's right, though. Like, 15 years? Okay, now I need to talk to the parents? Okay. Yo, Chloe, we gotta talk to them. Group SMS from Dana. Hayden as well. A Brooke. Yeah, Juliet. Juliet Watson. I forgot her name, her first name, when she showed up last time, right, in the last episode. I was like, she was Watson, but I forgot her name.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Okay, let me speak to James.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sera. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
What are you afraid Sera would do?
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sera would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. But Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sera brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
Do you think Sera is involved with any of the drug dealers around here?
It wouldn't surprise me if she were. That's who she is. Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
Okay, I will.
That is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss. Protect her from that. Please.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
Okay, I don't know. I want to talk to the wife, yeah. What is she gonna say? What does she feel? Rose.
Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
What? You're gonna divorce him?
Rose.
Do you need any help? Or sorry about tonight?
Sorry that tonight turned out so... differently.
That's all right. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Why?
Thanks. But why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, it's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
It's super weird.
I guess I'm not great. Rachel and I were really happy a few hours ago, and now...
Maybe you can see why James wanted to keep this a secret. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
And Sarah chose money.
Sarah shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
You know, I am so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband. His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
Okay. I guess we'll go up to Rachel. Okay, it's just starting right now. Opening, I mean. And she's most likely...
Rachel?
I mean, Sarah is most likely with... What's his name again? Damon? Damon? Damon.
Her room is so clean. Show Rachel that I'm here for her.
Emergency kit, laptop, planner. Okay, let me see the planner. Graffiti.
I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one?
Herbology.
That's the one.
Okay, we need to do something. This one, turn on.
This light needs more light.
What?
Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight.
Oh, what is this? This one, I can remove
Rachel
this.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool.
Good luck. Find a brighter light.
Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected.
Drawer.
I could get grades like this. I just don't want to.
Why, Chloe? Like, look at this. Tardy, zero. Perfect attendance.
I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird.
Ask, what is this? Like a Google search? Open. Got water. Batteries. Super, super bright. Okay, mom. Please. Okay, flashlight on this one. We could do that. Nice.
All ready for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first.
Okay, the stars. Close the lights, Chloe. But is it open already?
Hey. Check it out.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
It's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. Why? They remind us there's so much beauty out there. Which we almost never see. Sometimes we see it. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
I mean, it's still beautiful, though.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful. Right? I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore.
Dude, that's still your mom.
And that other woman. My real mom. She's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I'm honored.
I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination. Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
Oh, we can stand up if I like. What happens if I leave?
The fact that she's here right now. That she came here. For me. I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
I don't know.
Honestly, I have no idea what's right or wrong in this situation. I just know that whatever you decide, I'm in. But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad.
I have no idea where to start.
I got an idea.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
I think I can handle it. Yeah, we got a truck now, right?
I think I might be able to fix up that truck in the junkyard.
Really?
I'll give it my best.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
You'll know when it happens.
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.
I don't know what to say, man. Like, I don't know what to do. Like, what would happen, right, if he talked to Sera? Yeah, we haven't even seen her talk yet. Even once. Okay, another dream with Dad. On her outfit, Ariel outfit.
Dad, I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember
even
when
Victoria
we used to work on cars together?
Victoria.
Those are some of my favorite memories.
Or my memories.
Don't you mean my memories? I don't think you remember after you're dead.
Touche. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Okay, I'll play along. Here it is.
Fine. It's the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop.
None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
The world's a stage.
Something about the whole world being a stage. So, might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Oh no, we're gonna get hit again.
Dad.
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Oh my god. Yeah, this third episode is super emotional from the start.
Boo!
The hell, Victoria, shut up. Like, Victoria. You gotta change your clothes. Or take a shower
okay.
Or something.
I saw Sera leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. Plus, he likes me. And he owes me one from yesterday. I can do this. Come on, dude. Pick up.
Price, I got your collector's fee. Coming to get it?
Hey, Frank. I was actually gonna cash in for a favor instead. What do you say?
Never run out of crap, do you? What's the problem?
I need to find that woman from yesterday. Sera. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help?
I'm helping a friend.
I'm trying to help a friend. It would mean a whole lot to her.
The girl with you at the mill?
Yeah.
I'll meet in the junkyard in 2 hours.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real... That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into?
Okay, we got a message.
I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing.
What? She messaged us already? Okay, let's take a shower then. I don't know. Let me look at this. Why is it broken?
So much has changed. I wonder if you'd even recognize me now.
Yeah, I wish there was like a game where William is alive. But unlike the first, or unlike in the first game, right? Like nothing happened. Maybe
is
another timeline, right?
Mom playing music?
Like I want to see what happens. Like Chloe's still okay. Her dad's still okay. Something like that. rather than, yeah, her being paralyzed if we save William. It would be nice. Like, seeing like how Chloe, or what happened to her, what differences. Maybe she, like, she's super good at school or something like that, right? Or maybe she just still ends up like this. Who knows?
Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay.
Here?
My towel.
Okay, not there.
No awesome pirate towel.
Electric razor
is
also
there. Washcloths. No towel. I truly hate seeing so much of David's shit around here. Gross.
Was that manly grip?
I don't even know what's in there.
Like, I don't know where it is. Like, there's nothing there. Nothing here anymore. Medicine. Sub.
I don't even know what's in there. Score.
Oh, there's her towel. Oh, the blue!
Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids.
The blue hair color.
Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it.
Bombshell blue.
Ready for the best shower of my life.
Maybe she's also gonna wear her, what do you call that? A beanie as well? Okay, hopefully. Hopefully we can choose a color. Like the other ones, we could choose the outfits, right? Like earlier in episode 2, we could choose her outfit. Let's see. Was it colored already? Oh, magic. It's gonna be magic. Once she goes up, it's colored. A little bit for now. Okay, just a little bit. In the second game, it's all blue plus like pink in the middle, right?
I need new clothes.
Boots. William's clothes.
What do I feel like wearing on this crazy ass day?
Bonus outfits. Dragon bonus outfits. Skull. Let me see this. Illuminati. No, it's the same thing, right? No! Not that one again. I wore it already. No, not this one. I checked. Change. I'm used to, like, pressing a circle to go back. And we're basically activating another shirt. Bird skull. I think I wore this already, skull, right? The dragon. Oh, this is pretty cool. This one. Yes.
All right. One last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck.
Okay, we need to
Dad's
go...
Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs.
Downstairs.
Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
Yeah,
if your mom is happy like
time.
This, like, be happy for
I
her.
I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Right.
Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
What are you doing? Okay.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe. Coming home was a smart decision.
Well, it doesn't seem like home. No, I don't want to say that. Yeah, I am not staying long.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh. Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
Oh, don't worry. Hanging out with Rachel.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you.
Oh, David?
It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
David? What are you gonna say?
Chloe.
I don't have time for this.
Now, hold on a minute. Please. I owe you an apology.
Let's hear it.
Chloe, I should not have asked you to empty your pockets yesterday. I was, out of line. And I'm sorry.
Yeah, apology accepted.
Okay. Apology accepted.
Really?
Yeah. Good job. And good job, Mom, for twisting his arm or whatever.
Chloe.
What? It's great. He listens to you. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time.
Oh, what is it?
This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
Okay, let's just accept this. Yes, I don't want to be... Okay, let's accept it, accept it.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close.
I mean, of course, it's gonna be, like, it's traumatizing.
Thank you.
That's David. Why, like, oh, David is, like, super overprotective, right?
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell?
Rice cereals. Guns save lives. All of David's equipment are here now.
Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck.
Actually, like, I wish that when they made the remaster, like, we can start with this game before the storm, right? And then all our choices here would affect the first game. That would have been very cool. But no, they didn't do that. Yeah, because, like, look at this. Our choices with... like, earlier, like, David, we accept his apology. But, and when we started, like, Life is Strange... the first one, right? Like, Chloe is really, like, really mad at David. Or really angry.
God.
Fighting and everything.
Come on. Work with me here.
Better. But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast.
David. So 2010 right now. What year was it in Max again? 2013, right? So 2013, 2014. I don't remember, 2012, something like that. So basically, like, 2-3 years is the distance between this one and the first game.
I just need to find the right tool for each problem.
Fuel filter, intake tube, radio, Okay, fuel. Let's start from here, this one.
This thing is gunked the fuck up.
wait, we can blow? Okay, blow. What is that?
Maybe. Sick.
Check.
It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it?
Use the wrench. Mini games.
Much better.
Okay, distributor cap and radiator cap.
The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap.
Okay, let me use screwdriver or pliers? Screwdriver. Use it this one.
That should help keep shit distributed.
Oh!
Well, fuck.
Wait, what happened? She removed, reattached it.
Go back from whence you came.
Okay, the radiator, let me check that. No, this one. Yes.
This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else.
Okay, we're not gonna touch that. Intake tube.
Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be.
Graffiti, let me check that out first.
What do I see?
A raven.
I know.
Okay, I thought she was gonna use like the oil or something. Okay, battery post.
This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it.
Okay, use the pliers.
There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course.
Okay, I thought it crashed for a bit. Like it turned dark.
Please, I need you.
Oh, it's working.
We got it.
Oh. She's a genius. It's working. So how do you, what do you do, by the way? Like, if, for example, you don't have the key, right? Like, you only have, I mean, she's using, like, a screwdriver, like, to open this, right? To run this? So how do you get a key for this one? Yeah, just use it on that.
Junkyard Queen, where are you at?
Hey. Holy shit.
We got the same your outfit. Look
so
at our outfits.
Badass.
Exactly.
That shirt looks awesome too, I might add. You like anything that starts fire.
Hey, not sure if you saw. But someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Let's go. Oh, it's Frank.
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his
bar mitzvah.
Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
Hey, I thought we were cool after that Drew North thing. Don't you want to be cool?
Okay, we're cool.
I just want to talk to Frank. As long as you don't get in the way, we'll be fine.
I told you, she's like this.
Gotta say, I really dig the whole tough girl thing. Frank was right about you. How'd you like to work full time for us?
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me, but if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly it's a whole other thing? Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
I'll just be honest. Yes.
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Huh. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you, but he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now why you give a shit about this woman.
What do we say though? Why do you care so much? I mean, he might get angry, though. This one?
Why do you care so much?
Because... fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is now,
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your
pro- Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know.
No. Who cares?
So? We don't have anything to do with him.
Right. Here's what happens next.
What is that? Oh!
Come on, man.
Dude, that's a big knife.
They're just kids. No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
No. What are you doing, Rachel?
Ah, you fucking bitch!
Oh! Dude, oh my god. Well, thank god, it's just the arm, though.
What the fuck? Chloe! Go! Now!
Oh my god, I thought she was stabbed in the chest.
Hold on. Shit. Hey! Hold on, okay?
I mean, that big of a knife, even though it's just the arm? You'll bleed to death.
No. I'm not losing you.
We can't turn back time here. Dude, Rachel got stabbed in this game. So a lot of things still happened, even like before what happened to her in the first game. I want to talk to this lady, Sera, yes. Like, it's been an hour now in the episode. We haven't talked to her yet. Poor Rachel, man. She got stabbed like this. She just wanted to meet her mom. Her biological mom, I mean. What is this? Yeah, we haven't met these people.
Rachel is going to be all right.
Oh, thank God.
The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery. And now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
I'm trying to figure that out.
I don't know. Everything happened so fast. Do you know who Damon Merrick is? Or why he hates you?
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sera? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sera.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
To ask about Sera.
He asked us why we were so interested in Sera.
And what did you say?
Nothing, of course.
Is that how it became violent?
Rachel got angry.
It was actually Rachel who got angry. She was furious that he wouldn't tell her where Sera was.
This is exactly what I've been afraid of. Rachel won't let anything stop her.
She was protecting me too, or you could have helped her. You could have helped her.
If you let her meet Sera in the first place, we wouldn't have had to try something more desperate.
There are many things I wish I'd handled differently. What happened next?
Damon had a knife out, and we all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something. But when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream. But I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
And what about Damon?
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive. First of all, my department's been after him for some time. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah, I want to meet Sera now. Oh, Steph! She's here.
Hey.
Steph. How's Mikey?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay, sure. Definitely.
Okay, let's just go there then. Oh, is this their dad? Okay.
I don't think I can sit still any longer.
Out of order.
Well, stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up. Guess the citizens of Arcadia Bay aren't feeling so generous.
111. Okay, I can talk to him. Mr. Anthony.
All right, then. Thank you.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
You here to see Mikey?
Yeah.
How are things?
How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. Mikey's hurt, of course. But the doctors are saying it should heal up relatively quick. And Drew, Hey, maybe you heard. He's all set to go to Oregon State. Full ride for 4 years.
That's awesome.
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now. I have a question maybe you can answer.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well, guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
I don't know. Or you should ask Drew. No, I don't want to say that, though. I don't know.
No. Sorry. This weekend was actually the first time I really hung out with them.
That's all right. I appreciate that you've been keeping my boys company. Mikey said he feels a lot safer around you. He's been seeming a little scared these days. I think my work situation's disappointed him. Both of them. Actually, in different ways. Sorry I'm laying all this on you. I've been trying to keep it light in there.
That's okay.
Nice of you to listen. Do me a favor. Don't worry either of them with... Oh, excuse me.
Okay, let's go inside. Maybe we can play with Mikey.
Chloe.
Hey, you made it.
Hey, Chloe.
Yeah, I wish we could see them both in Life is Strange, right? How's your arm?
Hey. How's the arm, Mikey?
I wish it was the other one, so I could draw and stuff. But other than that, it's just broken.
Sweet hair, by the way.
I bet you could pull off Sailor Mercury.
Sailor Mercury.
Thanks.
Any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
Why? What happened?
Rachel was stabbed in the arm by Damon fucking Merrick.
Yeah, that's not funny. Shit. You serious?
Fuck that guy.
It wasn't because of me, was it?
We have our own problems.
Oh, no. We got our own set of problems with him.
That's crazy.
The whole thing makes me want to just... I swear, if I ever meet that shithead, I'm gonna...
What? What are you gonna do when you meet Damon Merrick?
Something terrible.
Uh-huh.
I am.
Like
a karaoke battle?
Challenge him to a karaoke battle?
Yeah, that's how we settle things on the street, huh?
Okay.
Throw dice at him.
Criticize his taste in film.
Okay.
Tell him about a band he's probably never heard of, but should have.
Enough. Anyway, we're glad Rachel's okay. You should hang out here till she wakes up.
Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready.
Okay, I can sign the cast.
Hey. Can I sign your cast?
Yeah, definitely.
Something nerdy. But not too nerdy.
Armor.
There you go.
Cool.
Oh. How about Steph and Drew?
say hi to Rachel for us.
We're rooting for her.
Okay, let's go. See you guys.
Hey. Wait up a sec. Sorry I got angry at you yesterday. About the money. You were just trying to help.
It's okay.
Don't worry about it. You were in a really tough situation.
A situation I created. When you said that Damon stabbed Rachel, I kept thinking, I'm supposed to look out for Mikey, not bring this shit into his life. I think you saved us from something so much worse. Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks for stopping by.
Bye, Chloe.
Dr. Bill Anderson? You saw that name, Dr. Bill? Okay, James. This, Mr. Amber. Okay. So the room is here.
Hey.
Oh, the firefighters.
Just heard the fire went out.
Okay, went the out. Fire went out, finally.
Hey.
Chloe, I can't even express thank you so much. I'm sorry. I'm a wreck. I stepped out to get some air. Rachel doesn't need me crying in front of her. Your hair. I almost didn't notice it.
Oh. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
I bet Rachel loves it. I can't imagine what I would do if we lost her.
It's going to be fine.
I'm sure everything's going to be fine.
That's what James keeps saying. He's so strong in a crisis, you know?
My dad was like that.
I'm sure he was. Just like his daughter.
We were lucky.
I just keep feeling like we were lucky. It could have gone so much worse, you know?
I'm sure it would have been if you weren't there for her. I am so glad you and Rachel have found each other. When you meet someone who changes everything, you just know.
Well, hang in there, Mrs. Amber.
I will.
I guess let's go in. It's this one, right? No. Rachel's room, okay.
Dad, I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
It really hurts.
Shh. The pain will pass. Chloe's here. You want me to stay?
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
I'll come back in a little while.
My guardian angel.
Steph says hey.
I saw Steph earlier. She says hey. Steph's so cute, but not as cute as you. Stop. I mean it. Rachel, I'm sorry. What? What for?
you're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard.
What? Shut up.
You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. And I'm so sorry.
And you saved my life. You saved my life.
I almost lost you.
I almost lost you. I can't believe I almost...
You're not getting rid of me that easy.
Good. Happy that your dad's here?
I mean, I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe.
Like on Mount Hood.
Would you do something for me?
Anything.
Sera. My mom. It's so weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her.
Are you sure?
Are you sure? She could be completely different than you imagine.
I'm sure. I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay. But if she is, will you find her? Please.
You really want this. Don't you?
I do, Chloe. I really do.
Then, of course. Whatever it takes.
I bet my dad has her number. Maybe in his office. Our house key's just under the mat. The code is 0722.
To your dad's office? 0722.
Yeah. My birthday.
I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are.
0722.
Thank you, Chloe. For everything.
Oh no, she's dying. No, she's just sleeping. She's good. Okay, we need to go to the house again. We're gonna have to break in. Oh, Elliot. Is that Elliot?
Hey, Elliot.
Hey! Wait. Your hair, it's different.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like it. It's nice. I like your shirt, too. I didn't know you were into dragons.
Who the fuck isn't into dragons?
Sorry about the Tempest.
Sorry I bailed on seeing the Tempest with you. The whole thing just sort of happened.
No, not a problem at all.
So, what's going on with you?
I don't even know where to start. At the moment, I'm here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here? What happened?
Do I tell him? I mean, it's just Elliot anyways.
She got stabbed by a psycho.
Oh my god.
Yeah. It was insane.
Holy shit. Wait, are you okay?
I wasn't stabbed.
I'm fine. She's fine too, by the way.
What is this conversation, man?
Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
Nothing we can't handle.
Chloe. I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately, right?
So what?
So, obviously, something is going on.
That's not your business, sir.
It's really not your business, Elliot.
Okay, that's fair. Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks. Anyway, see you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
Well, that was awkward as hell, man. Poor Elliot. I don't know why I keep like trying to have relationships with other characters, like in the first one with Warren, right? With Max. But in the end, I chose to save Chloe.
Hello?
I just wanted like this. I just wanted to see the scenes, yes. If there are any. I don't even know if what even happened to Warren afterwards, right? Did he live in the other game? Okay.
I need to search this office for any
Dad award.
Best dad. That stuff is all politics anyway.
Oh. What was that? What? Investigate.
Sweet. A secret key. Now to find the secret lock.
From Drew. Thanks. Let me check. Max. Maybe these weekend. Like, can we check the computer?
Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Okay, let me check the other ones. Nothing. Open it. Graffiti. Is it okay if I do this? I mean, it's the end of the game. Like, nothing will happen anymore. It's the end. I mean, it's the end of the episode. Or the last episode. Other side.
Welcome to Shadyville.
Open. Letters. The letters. A phone as well.
I have to know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sera.
Okay, what is this? We'll call tonight. I found who you were looking for. I talked to your girl. She has a big mouth.
James is working with Damon Merrick? This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sera? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sera is. But how do I get him to tell me?
Where is Sera? Or you'll pay. What evidence?
Shit. What do I say?
I did. Okay, what
Hope
do we do?
James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon will tell me where Sera is. Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Sheldon Pike?
Sheldon.
Who's this?
Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Yeah, I've never heard of a Sheldon before.
James has a file on Frank.
Oh, Frank Bowers.
I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
Shake. Okay, we can't go out. Let me check this one first. Open this. File box?
This must be what Damon was talking about. Shit.
Glove, knife,
casing.
Which of these
is Damon talking about? Huh. If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
Okay, what?
Could this be the evidence? Damon and knives seem like a solid bet. Did Damon really shoot someone? Guess I shouldn't be surprised.
Can we close this for now? Yeah, exit for now. We don't have anything. Let me check this one. Crime report. Okay. Okay, Damon Merrick. I see it now. 6'3". Very tall. Brandish a fire poker, hitting the victim several times about the head. before fleeing the scene, Merrick's gloves were recovered and entered into evidence. Okay, see. Merrick's gloves. This one. Okay, I need to destroy it now.
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
Yeah, burn it here, in the trash. Yeah, we're burning OJ's glove. Oh, okay.
Better not touch that again.
I don't know. No one. Yeah, I did something for you already. What the hell is your problem?
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is.
Imam.
Okay. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching. I should search around Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
No.
Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right.
Yeah, how do we do this then? Vendor headshot. Sunder headshot. Sheldon headshot. Sheldon.
This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment.
Or you could say it's Sheldon. Like, who cares, right? Thunder?
This guy let me into the mill. Cool dude.
Okay, not this guy. Frank. Accuse Frank? Hell no. Okay, let's accuse this dude, Sheldon, man. Wait, who's this one?
This guy looks like a real tool.
Yeah, we don't know this one. Yeah, this one, this dude. We can accuse anyone, I think, right? Now I need a payment?
Payment?
How much? Oh no, how do I know?
Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be?
Okay, look.
Guess I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home.
How do I know this then?
Feels a little weird having this guy's records at my fingertips.
Anything here that we can show the money? Sawdust. What is this?
I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Investigate.
Holy shit. Fuck, that's Sera. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her?
Why is she tied up like that? Let her go. Fine.
Shit. Does James even know what he's doing? Okay. I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
Who's that? What, is it James?
Elliot?
Elliot?
Hey!
What?
Elliot, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here? This is Rachel's house, right?
The way you're following me.
Did he really just follow me here?
You followed me?
Did you follow me from the hospital?
I did. I'm worried about you.
I'm fine. You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe, what is...
Elliot, put that down.
My God, what is this dude?
You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, God, what have you gotten yourself into?
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
It's none of your business.
Honestly, Elliot, you can judge me all you want, but it's pretty fucked up that you're here right now, and I don't have time for this.
When?
What?
When will you have time? For me? You have all the time in the world for Rachel.
Oh my God.
I'm so sick of you not seeing who Rachel really is. When will you realize what she's doing to you?
Elliot, just take a step back.
No. You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
She saved me.
You don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
Stop suggesting that she's somehow bad.
The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble. And you get suspended.
She defended me.
Rachel was there for me. She did everything she could to protect me.
I guess it wasn't enough, huh?
You don't understand. You weren't there.
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in?
God, look. I'm sorry I ditched you for the play, but...
This isn't about that.
No, it's about that.
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before...
I've been quiet long enough. Look, Rachel is an amazing actress. And I don't mean on stage. She's fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
Elliot. I promise. No one is manipulating me.
No? Just look where you are now. A high school dropout. Hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy! It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened...
I appreciate the concern.
Look, I hear you. I appreciate the concern.
I don't think you do.
Elliot.
I'm the one who cares about you, Chloe. Me, not Rachel.
It's time you saw the truth.
What does that mean?
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
What the hell is this dude? Calm him.
Elliot, please. I know you're upset, but—
I'm not upset! I'm trying to help you.
I'm gonna call for help.
Elliot's gone full-blown crazy.
What the hell is this anyway?
I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me. We have a lot to talk about. And I don't care how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
This dude, man.
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad? Let's talk.
To succeed, okay.
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
Here's what's going on. We're at the DA's house, and we should probably leave before he comes back.
Don't worry. With Rachel in the hospital, James isn't coming anytime soon. I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
You're keeping me here.
You're the one who's keeping
me here.
Oh
no, I got it wrong.
At the Arcadia Bay DA James Amber's house.
You're acting strange. What's going on?
What? Nothing.
No.
You bitch! Can't you see? I just want to help you!
You shouldn't have talked with this guy.
You're going to assault me now? That's how far you'll go to protect Rachel? This is what I'm talking about.
No, you idiot.
What the fuck?
Better run, dickbag. Cops will be here any minute.
Daughter gets stabbed. House gets broken into. I was like, what the hell was that scene, man? You didn't need that scene. Look at everything that the fire destroyed.
So much destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life, and he's still lying.
Hey, being a dad's tough.
William is here.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap.
I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I think you didn't.
I think you didn't. You didn't have to. You didn't, right?
Would you love me less?
Of course not.
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
I am ready.
Ready as I'll ever be.
Problem is, I'm dead. So how am I supposed to tell you anything?
Okay. Yeah, they're just making it longer now.
I wish you'd told me.
Yeah, they're stalling a lot.
You don't like the perfect relationship we had?
I wish you'd lived long enough for us to fuck it up. No way. My ride, my tunes. Seriously, going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel? Am I crazy?
Hella crazy.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
Nah. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real.
What's gonna happen now? Are we gonna go there now? Okay, we're here. I thought they would like stall even more.
Shit. Is that blood?
Maybe that's blood from Merrick? I mean, he stabbed Rachel, don't know.
Frank?
Pompidou. they're gonna survive. They're in the other
Frank.
Game.
Shit, this is bad. I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom.
Oh, I also got burned.
Where the hell is Sera?
Yeah, it really got burned. The couch. Phone. Sheldon. Swipe.
No!
Shh. Everything's going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
I just want to meet my daughter.
Can't you understand? Why does
he... Your daughter? Jesus. So that's what he's worried about. Can't let the public know. The mother of his daughter is some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to...
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture. So that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
I've got your money.
I've got your money right here. The money James owes you?
How the fuck do you...
Run! No one has to know. Just let her go, and I won't say...
Oh my god.
No!
Talking's over.
Leave her alone!
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Oh my god.
Get away from her!
I said shut the fuck up!
Oh, no!
No!
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon!
Oh!
What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man.
Fuck you.
Sera. Rachel. Your daughter. She... Sera?
What
Chloe
happened?
Price.
You know my name?
You know who I am?
I saw you in the play. You were funny.
Thanks.
Sit.
Sera, are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry for...
Rachel can never know.
Know about what?
What exactly can't Rachel know?
What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with...
He's a piece of shit. And I promise that...
Rachel can never know.
I don't understand.
Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar.
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever.
She deserves to meet you.
And just what is James protecting her from? You? She wants to meet you, Sera.
No, she doesn't. She wants to meet her mother. I can never be that for her.
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken.
Everybody's broken, Sera.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away?
You're here now. That's what matters.
What do you know?
I know Rachel needs you. I know loss.
I lost my father.
I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it.
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
You quit for a year.
I heard what Damon said. You've been sober for a year. You beat this before. You can beat it again.
No. I can't.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
They are far from perfect.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
And don't you want to see her?
Don't you want to see her? You came here for it. You got sober. You deserve the chance to know your daughter.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her, protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt. So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Wait!
Don't leave.
Don't go, Sera.
I'm done here. Goodbye, Chloe.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe another tat is in order. To go with the one you gave me.
Fuck yeah.
We never actually escaped. Did we?
We've got time.
All the time in the world. So, how did everything go?
Rachel, I've got to tell you something.
Oh no, I gotta tell her. Do I protect Rachel or tell her everything? Hard decisions this time. I mean, like Sera keeps pushing. Like Sera's gonna be back to being a druggie again. Because Damon, like, drugged her, right? So that's out. So if I tell Rachel everything, that it was James, like, she might end up with a broken family? Maybe, right? But if I protect her from this, she's gonna live, like, normally. until you know what happens in the first game, right? But Chloe will know this. Like, Chloe doesn't want to lie. But for Rachel? Okay, I gotta choose this, man. I'm sorry. But I gotta protect the Rachel, or I gotta protect Rachel from the truth. Yeah. I can't. Yes, yes.
Hey. What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny. You seemed so confident. I really thought you'd find her. Yeah. Me too. Maybe we can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet. Of course. I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much. How do you know that? Because, why should she be any different from the rest of us?
Hopefully it was the right decision for me, at least. I like, look at this. I mean, like, look at Chloe, like, see? Like, Chloe doesn't like that she hit it. But yeah, Rachel still got her family, even though her dad is, like, a horrible person. But yeah, man, maybe if I didn't know what happened in the first game, I would probably say the truth, right? Oh, he's proposing. Homie's proposing. Yes, yes, he said. Is that this Elliot? Is it Elliot? What is wrong with you, homie? Oh, Steph! Steph, Mikey, and Drew. Oh, they're playing, all of them. I like the side characters here, like Steph, Mikey, and Drew. Ah, yes, what happened to her? She left as well. That's why she's not on the first game. What's her name again? Sam? Right, Sam. Victoria. Evan? This is Evan, right? Principal. I wonder what's the scenes, if, like, we told her the truth, right? Yeah, what is the scenes? I want to see both endings, like, different outcomes. Oh, what the hell? They're flipping off your former principal. Oh, the lighthouse. Oh, we're back. No, is this this is Rachel? I thought it was like Chloe, like back then. Oh, she colored all of her hair now. I want to see what the other ending is. Like, if they are still like this, and when we see the truth, right? Oh, she has her tats now. Oh, she also have a tat on her leg, Rachel. When did like Frank and Rachel hook up then? Right in the first game? Like both of them hook up. So this year, or this one, was set in 20... What year was it? 2010, right? Okay. So this game was set in 2010, this one before the storm. The other game, the first game was like 2013, I think, or 2014, something like that. So it's 3 years, 3 or 4 years before all of the things happens with Max. But yeah, all in all, this game, I kind of love it. I kind of like this game. But in this episode in particular, yeah, we didn't have a lot of Rachel. Like, I wish we had confronted Damon with Rachel. I don't know, in the second part, I mean, right? The second one in the old mill. Like, I wish that Rachel didn't get stabbed, didn't go to the hospital or anything. I wish she was with Chloe, yes. I think I would have liked it like that better. Because this is their story, basically. Yeah, and in the third episode, we had less of her. And she was a lot of the time. Like, we had her at the start, and then she went to the hospital. And then we went to the important parts, and she was not there. Yeah, that was just it. But game is very nice. I like the story. I keep saying it. And it is very fun. No powers, no nothing like that. Just a good story. And by the way, we also have a bonus episode. Yes. We have one more episode that we're gonna play, but Chloe and Rachel's story is over. This is over for them. For the bonus episode, it's gonna be Max and Chloe when they were kids. Yes, basically. I think it was before Max left. Yeah, the bonus episode. Yeah, we'll check that. We'll check that in the next one, next part. So this one is basically, we just finished Chloe and Rachel's story. I'll give it a... What did I give the first one? I don't remember. I actually don't remember what score I gave the first one. Or did I even give a score to the first one? But this one I'll give like an 8 out of 10. Yes, 8 out of 10. 8 or 8.5 out of 10. Yeah, something like that. That's lovely. So after we finish this, we're gonna try True Colors or Life is Strange 2. We'll just see. But I'm pretty excited for Life is Strange 2. It's pretty much... I don't know, Life is Strange 2. True Colors, yes. It's pretty much the newest one, so... Like, I wanna see what kind of graphics they have in that one. Hopefully it's good as well. But yeah, it works, honestly, even without powers, like the first game. Yeah, the game works just like this, right? Like, it's still good, even we don't have any, like, powers or anything. Still nice to play. So can we just skip this? Okay. 51% of people. Okay. What is this? Seventeen missed calls, Chloe calling. Oh my god, this is the one in Life is Strange, right? Oh no. Yeah, when they were taking pictures of Rachel, Mr. Jefferson, what the f- No, okay. Yes, this is the last episode that we're gonna see, this one. Okay. So yeah, oh my god, that was kinda... Like, it's horrific, honestly, like... You know what's happening there, it was Mr. Jefferson, I don't know, it's Nathan or Mr. Jefferson, right? Taking the photos, but Nathan was the one who overdosed her. Dude, I forgot about this. Yes, that... what do you call this? Rachel died by overdose, right? They said. And her mom, or her biological mom, was a junkie. Ah, my god. That is pretty sad, man. And they showed it like that? That they were taking pictures and Chloe was calling her and she couldn't reach her? Okay, so next episode, we'll do the bonus one, guys. So I'll just see you then. Bye-bye.